many of them, but some were chosen and they were put on this little card here. And so it's like a box of chocolates sometimes. Alisa, floor 2, row L, seat 5. Alisa, are you there? Alisa? There you are. Oh, don't be shy. Stand up, Alisa. Come on. You look lovely. Alisa wants to know, what for you has been the best part about moving to New York? Oh, good question. The best part for me about moving to New York, well, my dog loves New York because he barks at the ponies because he thinks they're just large squirrels or something. The best part for me is that I get to walk. I think the coolest thing for me is that I get to actually walk around. I'm the kind of person that if I'm living, I grew up in Los Angeles, still love LA, but you're always thinking about parking and getting in the car and going places. And if I have an excuse to be a hermit, I'll be a hermit. So the best thing for me about New York is that I get to go out and I say, screw it, whatever's gonna happen is gonna happen. And I walk out the door. And then when you walk out, there's all this amazing arts and culture and all that stuff. Yeah, thanks for the question. Good for the gams. Good for those ballet legs. Christine, section 101, row 23, seat 3. Christine, are you around? I can't see a wave if you're up there. Where are you? Over here! Are you in the light? Okay, where are you, Christine?
There she is.
Oh my god, you're way up high. Okay, hi there. Christine wants to know, if you could sing with anyone dead or alive, who would it be? Bob Marley, I think, would be good for me. I'm not saying it would sound right, but it would be fun for me. Or I would have loved to have been on the Pavarotti and Friends shows, because he was just to me like the great, great, great voice of all time. And he was kind of the original crossover guy, because he had no problem going out and, you know, bringing out people like Bono and Tina Turner and all different sorts of styles and bringing them to classical music, which I thought was really cool. And I'm very glad I missed out on that era of shows. But thank you for your question. And also secretly Scooby-Doo. Laura, floor 1, row D, seat 14. Laura, Laura. Oh, hello, you are close. You're in the spit zone. Put on your plastic poncho. Can I come up and sing with you?
Aww.
Anything you choose, I will not let you down. I promise. It's a long text. Really?
Come on.
If we do this, you better bring it. Do you have some water or a Gatorade or anything? Have some here. Full service concert here. You just drink that and enjoy what it feels like to experience awkward silence. Forcing through your veins, that awkwardness. Awesome. Well, did you have anything in mind that you wanted to sing? Are you gonna? Don't let me pick, because I'll get into, you know. The prayer? Do you know the prayer? A little bit? Enough? Mark? Oh.
I pray you will be our light
and watch us where we go.
Lead us to a place.
Hide us.
When you let a fan upstage you at your own concert.
Uh-oh.
Here's how it went down for Josh Groban after he pulled a fan up on stage. Have a look.
I pray we are alive.
And watch us where we
So cute. Just a random fan said he would sing a couple notes, and he ended up giving her the microphone and letting her finish the song. Like,
nice
there you go.
Her.
I know. All right, pull out the motorized carts and shaggin' wagons. Lloyd and Harry may be road tripping again. In a recent interview, Jim Carrey said he's thinking of bringing back some of his old characters. That may include doing another Dumb and Dumber. That's the first time Jim spoke to rumors of a part two, which started swirling back in March. So excited for that. And Paul McDonald may not be an American Idol, but he did win the heart of a Twilight starlet. The soulful crooner and Nikki Reed have been dating for only 2 months, but already they're engaged. Apparently, she confirmed it to some peeps at the MTV Movie Awards, where they also showed off their matching tattoos. Hope they put the cost of that tattoo removal in the prenup. Just saying. It's cute, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, they got each other's names, like, tattooed right inside these fingers here, and she's got a little rock that she's wearing, and she said he's the one. They asked her, you know, how are
cool
you guys doing? And she said he's absolutely the one.
And coming up, we're going to be talking about some cool wedding ring
Ooh,
trends
yeah.
for 2011, too, so you don't want to miss that.